Hello friends, welcome to Geeks for Geeks. In this video, we will discuss the optimal substructure property of dynamic programming problems. We say that a given problem has the optimal substructure property if the problem can be solved optimally by using the optimal solutions of its subproblems. The dynamic programming techniques exploit this property to split the problems into smaller subproblems and solve them instead. This is useful because after the subproblems become sufficiently small, solving them becomes trivial. These trivial solutions can then be used to solve the superproblems and arrive at the final result. Let's take the example of the shortest path problem. The problem says that we are given a graph and we are required to find the shortest path from source vertex U to destination vertex V. Say that X is a vertex that lies on the shortest path from U to V. Then, the path from U to X has to be the shortest path from U to X. Similarly, the path from X to V has to be the shortest path from X to V. So, we see that the shortest path problem can be optimally solved by using optimal solutions to subproblems. In fact, the standard all-pair shortest path algorithms like Floyd-Warshall and Bellman-Ford are typical examples of dynamic programming problems. Let's now take a counterexample. Consider the longest path problem. Given a graph, it requires us to find the longest path without any cycle from a source vertex U to a destination vertex V. Consider the shown unweighted directed graph. There are two longest paths from Q to T, Q, R, T, and Q, S, T. However, the longest path from Q to T, that is Q, R, T, is not a combination of the longest path from Q to R, that is Q, S, T, R, and the longest path from R to T, that is R, Q, S, T, as this combination contains a cycle. So we see that the longest path problem is not an example of dynamic programming problems. That's all for now. Thank you for watching.